I felt like I was this close to getting a deal with somebody just because my music was good and I had like a little bit of connections to the industry. But I had just graduated college. I was broke, nigga. I was like struggling to pay my rent. I ain't had no job. And I was kind of being complacent because I had crazy music. And I was kind of chilling, like as if that was good enough to get me to where I needed to go.
Yeah.
And I had a realization. One time, nigga, I'm in a party. I'm drunk and I'm high. So I had to leave the party and go to the backyard. So I'm back there paranoid, like, oh my God, like, nigga, I'm going through it. Nigga, life is on me, nigga, rent. All my college friends went and got jobs. Nigga, I'm over here doing some rap shit. And these niggas walk in the backyard to come find me. And they like, yo, we want to holler at you right quick. Bro, it turned into an intervention. These niggas was like, hey, bro, what you doing? You say you want to do this music shit, but like, all you doing is really just like hanging out, partying this shit. Mind you, one part of me is like, nigga, yo, I be with y'all niggas. Like, the fuck are you talking about? But when they was talking, bro, I swear to God, I sobered up quickly. It was almost like I was on a stage. Nigga, literally, after that, I thought about basketball. Why I ain't making basketball? Nigga, I love to play. And at this point, I'm 21 years old, you know what I mean, 22. And I'm like, nigga, why you didn't make it in basketball? Because you wasn't fucking working. You thought you'd be outside dribbling the fucking ball, doing something, when really niggas was in the gym with trainers, like putting in work, shooting 1,000 shots a day. And your dumb ass over there thinking you doing something, mimicking Iverson. Yeah. So it was like, yo, do you really want to look back 10, 20 years from now with this music shit and be like, the reason you didn't make it in music because you ain't put in the work? So I was like, fuck it. That was where the warm-up came from. Every day, nigga, I woke up, wrote verses, made beats. So, and so all that to say, the off-season was like the same concept. Like,
right.
One more time before I leave, like, before I feel like I'm, like fulfilled in this game, let me try to reach new heights from a skill level standpoint.
What's good? It's TimelessRoc with TR Mentality, man. Before we get into the video, make sure y'all own y'all own shit. Let's get into the intro. In this clip, we got J. Cole talking about how his friends stopped him from losing everything. First off, man, this is the reason why you gotta have the right people around you at all times. Because literally, like I said, if you have people around you that don't believe in what you're doing and you know they just having fun doing what they doing, and if you sticking around with them, you know they might not even ever talk about the music. They not gonna say, hey, man, you supposed to be doing music, right? They'll just sit there and let you just do whatever you want to do and don't even ask what you want to do in life. You gotta have people that want to see you actually win. So whenever you talk about what you want to do in life, they actually want to have that conversation. You know what I'm saying? They want to talk to you about your future and they want to talk to you about your dreams and your passions and everything like that. And when y'all do have those conversations, they're going to make sure that you go ahead and you stick to that and you actually make sure you're doing everything you're supposed to do to make that dream come true. You know, letting you know, yo, bro, I see what you're doing, man. Keep going with that shit. And if you're falling off, they'll let you know, bro, like, what the fuck is you doing, my guy? I ain't see you drop no music lately. I ain't see you put out content lately. What is you doing, my guy? Step it up. And if you out bullshitting, you know, they're going to let you know, like, get back on your shit, because if you losing, they losing at the same time and in a certain sense. He also was talking about, man, work ethic in this video, man. He talked about how he wanted to go to the NBA growing up. He was like, bro, he had to come to the realization that he was not putting in the work needed to make it to the NBA as much as the people that actually made it to the NBA, what they was doing every day to make their dream come true. And I be speaking about this too, man. I always speak on, like, bro, like, I've never worked so hard on anything in my life before this music. And I'm in the same boat as him. Growing up, I wanted to go to the NBA. You know what I'm saying? And I be having these same conversations like, yo, I wasn't working hard enough at basketball. As much as I wanted to think I was back then, I wasn't doing as much as I should have been doing. Like he said, like, you think, oh, you going outside, you just dribbling around, you counting down 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, shooting from half court and shit like that. You think you really gonna get good at hooping. And yeah, you might get better, bro, but like, it's people out here really training with people that they paying per session and everything like that. And even if they ain't paying for their sessions, they actually got somebody who training with them and actually helping them get better. They pushing them every single day. And it's like, even if you out there shooting around, like I said, you might get a little better, bro, but you're not gonna be at the same level as these type of people. And it's the same with music, bro. Like, if you want to be hot as an artist and you want to make better songs and you want to be able to make the best music you possibly can, you have to be in the studio every single day. You have to be in the studio as much as possible. If every day ain't possible, you got to make sure you get in there as many times as you possibly can. And that way you can truly grow at your craft. And just like making these videos, you got to put out as many videos as you possibly can and you got to be consistent with it, or else you're going to fall behind everybody else. And if that happens, you cannot blame nobody else but yourself. So if you somebody that don't want to look back and regret nothing and be like, man, damn, I could have been further if I'd have done this or if I'd have done this. Make sure you go ahead and you take this video, man. Share this with somebody that you fucking with. Share this with somebody who need to get on their shit. Share this with somebody that's on their shit. And just get started on your grind today. But hey, man, I'm going to go ahead and leave y'all on that note, man. Y'all go ahead and let me know down in the comments section how y'all feel about what I'm talking about. Y'all let me know how you feel about the topic. And hey, man, if you fucking with what I'm talking about, you agree with me, man, make sure you go ahead and leave a like. And if you're new to the channel, go ahead and subscribe. And I'm out of here, man.
Most of these niggas out here be lame. I can't fuck with nobody, nobody on the same thing. Shawty quick to dummy and I know.